Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. On August 6, 2012, the NASA rover Curiosity touched down on the planet Mars to begin the latest investigation into the Martian environment. It seems that NASA's scientists are most curious about whether Mars could have ever supported microbial life. Beyond this, much discussion in the science media has centered on internet hoaxes and misunderstandings that have duped many in the general public. Based on the NASA press releases, one is left to wonder, do any real mysteries remain for Curiosity to explore?
Well, it is true that there's a great deal of rumor mongering on the internet, and this gives NASA officials an opportunity to correct misinformation and to be more informed on the subject than those who are spreading the rumors. But there is an irony in all of this. Here on the surface of Mars today, we have a rover named Curiosity. And this rover is a witness to stupendous technological achievement. But the irony is that within the theoretical sciences today, Curiosity is absent. Here we have a laboratory in space, the planet Mars, which offers such a unique opportunity for discovery in the sciences. But the questions are not being asked. Just consider, for example, the mystery of the Martian profile as a whole, where you have such a split personality, completely unexplained. Two hemispheres so radically different. In the north, virtually no craters. In the south, dense cratering. How could that be? We make assumptions about planetary evolution and hold on to those assumptions for decades after they've stopped working.
The mysteries surrounding Martian geology may run far deeper than the general public have been led to believe.
The key piece of evidence is the shape of the planet. The northern hemisphere is actually lower than the southern hemisphere. And it's not just that that planet was somehow squeezed into an odd shape. The definitive consideration is the crustal depth. For reasons that no planetary scientist has explained, the crust of the northern hemisphere has been excavated. It's been eaten away, up to 6 miles deep. And there is one force only that could achieve hemispheric excavation of a planet. That force is electric discharge in an age of planetary instability and violence.
A reconsideration of Martian geology could challenge many of the underlying assumptions of planetary science.
Planetary scientists have long maintained that you can date the surfaces of rocky planets and moons by counting craters. This would make the southern hemisphere of Mars a billion years older than the northern hemisphere. But if Mars was engulfed in electric discharge in the past, one of the first questions to ask is whether that pervasive cratering in the southern hemisphere could be explained by electric arcs. And electrical experiments by plasma scientists C.J. Ransom of Vemusat Laboratories showed that production of craters by electric arcs can also generate the telltale markers that you see on the planet Mars, including the central darkened bumps of so many craters and the general darkening of the heavily cratered terrain. These are not patterns that would be expected from random bombardment by rocky bodies from space over a billion years.
The cratering patterns created by high-energy plasma discharge to a solid surface may help explain the many anomalous crater forms on Mars.
It really is a fact that textbook theory does not account for Martian cratering patterns. Bizarre hexagonal craters, for example. A hexagon is a common trademark of electric discharge. So-called bullseye craters, where one crater centers on another beyond all probability. Craters with towering central peaks that terminate in another crater. Finely terraced crater floors and crater walls. Huge mesas sitting squarely within a surrounding crater. Sharply scalloped walls, as seen in the case of the famous Victoria crater. Also, the endless strings of craters or crater chains. And what about craters with central spherical domes? Incredibly enigmatic. Is it a coincidence that Dr. Ransom got exactly the same form in electric discharge to a Martian-type soil? The cratering mysteries on Mars are just the beginning. And if NASA will open the door to an electrical interpretation, a different picture of solar system history is certain to follow.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.